In previous session, we have seen that various items cannot be included under the definition of capital asset. In that, first item is stock in trade. See, in this session, let's focus on the stock in trade. Any stock in trade, consumable stores, raw materials which are held for the purpose of business or profession of the assessee cannot be construed as capital asset. And when we say stock in trade, this is going to be other than the securities which are referred in clause B of section 2 subsection 14. Okay, so what is the clause B says? Any securities held by foreign institutional investor which has invested in such securities in accordance with SEBI regulations. Okay, see, those securities will be called as capital asset. Okay, so other than that, if they are stock in trade, they will not be treated as capital asset. Okay, so this exclusion of stock in trade from capital asset definition is only with reference to clause A, that is, property of any kind held by an assessee, whether or not connected with his business or profession. Okay, so only with reference to that it is given. Okay, so it is not with reference to clause B. So what is that it implies? If foreign portfolio investor is holding stock in trade, and even if the nature of that security is stock in trade, it will still be treated as capital asset, and any profits, okay, on account of transfer of that asset will be treated as capital gain. And for this, there is also an explanatory memorandum to Finance Bill number 2, 2014, which clarifies that if there is any income arising from the transfer of a security by foreign portfolio investor, okay, it will be treated as capital gain. It would be in the nature of capital gain. Let whatever be the presence or otherwise, I mean, irrespective of the presence or otherwise in India of the fund manager who is managing the investments of the assessee.